Jason, we're just at the start of seventh season, and you're a man who captained Wales for a couple of years back in the early noughties.
Yeah, gosh, it seems a long time ago now, and it's certainly moved on as a sport. You know, it's going into the Olympics, so it just goes to show how much sevens has actually come on in the world.
You talked about obviously an inclusion as an Olympic sport. The sport of sevens is growing year on year here in the UK. What is it that you think really appeals to supporters about the format?
Well, it's just a great spectacle. I mean, you can see when you watch it on various channels on the TV, you know, the crowds, that they come in their thousands. You know, you see probably some of the stars of tomorrow as well. A lot of youngsters get the opportunity to actually blood their skills, you know, their fitness, their passing, their catching, the speed of thought. You know, it's a cruel place on a field of sevens, to be honest with you, because you can get cruelly exposed defensively if you're not on the button, but also it's there for the quick-witted and the good minds and quick thinking of players to spot a gap and exploit those.
Of course, back in your day with Wales, you mentioned it's about the young players coming through now, but there was quite a star-studded team, yourself included, in most teams that took part in the Commonwealth Games of 2002.
Yeah, it was, you know, it's a great occasion, obviously, to represent your country in anything, but playing in a major tournament. I think I was at Manchester in 2002, so we were in the UK, unfortunately, with that, but it was a great experience. You know, I think the likes of Gareth Thomas, Rob Howley, who's the current backs coach for Wales, now was in there, Matthew Robinson, Arwell Thomas. So it was a great experience. Unfortunately, we were knocked out in the quarterfinals against a rampant New Zealand side. But it, you know, it's a great experience to represent your country, and especially in a big games like the Commonwealth Games. And it's great for these, whether you're young, you're inexperienced, or you're experienced, to go out there and learn those skills that you need to actually maybe push yourselves on. And it's a stepping stone, could be, for people who actually want to push for honours at 15 a side code.
The Olympics coming up, and the curtain raiser for that will be the Premiership Rugby Sevens. That starts next Friday at BT Sport Cardiff Arms Park, and the Dragons actually defending their title. What did you make of the performance of the Dragons and some of those players last year in lifting the title?
Well, it was great. I'm probably a surprise as well, if we're honest, that they won the competition against a star-studded Wasps side. And, you know, the likes of these youngsters, like we talked about, you know, they actually took their chances very well. The likes of Ashton Hewitt, Angus O'Brien, you know, the young lad that played in the under-20s, and Harry Keddy, you know, they went there, rolled their sleeves up and get on with it. And you know, they went out there, they had no fear, and they went out there and won the title in a very competitive league structure, as it was with the Premiership sides as well in England, and they lowered all their flags.
And with that victory, presumably some confidence came to those players who went on to notch up quite a few games for the Dragons in the last season.
And that's what it's about. It's the development of these young players. Whether we have that same, we're allowed to use the same players this year around, you know, a year makes a big difference. Now they've established themselves in the regional sides. Maybe it's time for some of the other youngsters to actually step up to the plate and get their opportunity to go and defend the title that Newport Gwent Dragons won last year.